In 1578, Elizabeth I stayed with Lord North at Kirtling on the edge of the Cambridge Fen. And the menu was a fens special. There was 110 bitterns, 270 mallard, 68 godwit, 445 quail, 99 dotterel, plus crane and shoveler and a whole range of different species. The fish included sturgeon, three sturgeon, and carp and tench and perch and roach and pike. So this illustrates the wonderful richness of the fens upon which so many people depended. And then this was, it's a crane calling, and then this was largely drained in the 17th century, followed by further drainage and intensification. And Ian Rotherer, in his book The Lost Fens, points out that this is probably the greatest ecological catastrophe that England has ever faced. Although these wetlands, when created, recreated, such as here at Lake and Heath Fen, are wonderful, wetlands are quite forgiving habitats, they don't have the many of the species that were once present. So pond turtle and Dalmatian pelican, or large copper butterfly, or burbot, or wild boar. So in Daniel Pawley, the Canadian fisheries biologist, introduced the idea of shifting baselines, in which each generation accepts a smaller catch and smaller individuals, just assuming that that's what's possible. So it could be that although these habitats are fantastic and really enjoyable to be at, they're actually a poor imitation of the original magnificent habitats.